This is Snake. I'm staring at the I'm blinking at the screen. This is a tactical espionage action game called Metal Gear Solid. All right, let's do this dance. Welcome to the Experience Bar's Part 3 stream of Metal Gear Solid. This is the third part of the stream. Previously on Metal Gear, we blew up a Hind D with Liquid Snake in it. Took down our evil nemesis. Looked like a badass with explosions going off in the background. And now we're climbing down a ladder like a badass with no explosions going off. But, yeah. Welcome. In honor of the forthcoming Metal Gear Solid The Phantom Pain, that'd be the fifth Metal Gear Solid, we're playing through the first Metal Gear Solid, which, you know, for my first two streams, I would say holds up pretty well. Especially if you're playing in analog mode. So, yeah. If you're... we're about, I'd say, probably halfway through the game right now. So, let's continue onward and see if we can't stop these evil terrorists from launching a nuke. Oh, right, right. Stairwells with guns. Ah! Okay. Check grenades. What? Come on. Just run. Hello, everyone. Just run. I'm gonna throw this one before I get there. That way it blows up. Nope. Timing's off. Just wasted half my life. Stupid guns. Throw it now. Nope. I'm still terrible at that. My last ration, because I suck. You know what? I'm going to equip the body armor just in case I do keep screwing up. Because I have body armor. That's another thing that's super useful. Man, they just really make... Like, this whole stairwell is just to make you waste all your chaff grenades. Like, why else would you design something like this? Hey, there's that stack of boxes that magically moved. Alright, get all that stuff. And now we're gonna go back on the elevator that, wasn't working last time we were here. Otacon said it started moving. So, let's give it a shot in just a sec here, actually. I'm gonna make sure the stream is working. Seems like it's working. Cool. Do this. Hit the button, Snake. Don't need these anymore. It actually shows him wearing a vest now. If I unequip this. No vest. Green vest. No vest. Green vest. It's the little things. Huh? Huh? What kind of elevator only has, like, just 9-1? Like, you get, like, halfway up... Oh, shit, I shouldn't have taken the stairs. Also, why doesn't it go to the top of the tower? Like, you get to level 9 and you have to walk the rest of the way? That's a terrible idea.
Snake! There's something I forgot to tell you before.
What?
There were 5 stealth camouflage prototypes in my lab.
Yeah?
So okay.
If you take out the one I'm wearing, that leaves 4.
Hey, this isn't first grade math class.
I thought I'd get one for you. So I went back to the lab and...
Yeah?
The 4 suits were missing. Also, about the elevator that I checked out, it's really strange. It was like someone was intentionally...
You mean the one I'm currently riding on?
Riding on it. Did the weight limit warning go off?
That's another thing that bothered me about it. The warning went off, and I know I couldn't be over the limit.
How much do you weigh?
Snake is way ahead of you, man.
135, but that elevator had a
weight. Holy shit. Otacon's a welterweight.
It would take at least five people to go over that limit.
Look out, Snake! The guys who stole my stealth prototypes
just
are in
totally
there
worth the animation budget to have Otacon's face right up in your grill there. Okay, this is gonna be real interesting, because, like, I have no health left, but... Come on. Why won't these guys die? Jeez. Oh, I'm out of... Oh, damn it. I should have picked up the ration first. I have no idea. It's like a cargo elevator in an industrial building that has a five-person weight limit, and all those people are Japanese because they only weigh 135 pounds, apparently. It's a 500-pound weight limit. That carries, like, 2.5 Americans. Like, that's terrible. Like, two dudes my size would set the... a little heavier than me, but, like, two big, burly dudes would set that elevator weight limit off. That's ridiculous. You're right, Coaster Freak. Now watch me waste all my chaff grenades again. Oh, my God. Okay, well, at least I have the chance to not hurt myself intentionally a whole ton. I'm just throwing these well ahead of time now. That way it goes off before I even get to the thing. It's already gone off by the time... Well, now I'm throwing them too early. So I need to go down two sets of stairs before I throw it, or it's going to run out early. Alright, so it's already tricked. See, much better at it now. Oh, hey, I got here. So I only got shot once that time. This will probably help quite a bit. Also, kind of ominous that they give you all these FAMAS bullets, like, right before you get on the elevator. I'm gonna re-equip that body armor again. Yeah, I got enough life. Bunny armor snake. A surveillance camera? Nope. I like that you can just run around in there and there's no inkling of those guys, but this is a great moment, like the first time you're playing this game, because you're obviously, like Snake, adding it up before Otacon tells you what's going on.
Snake.
It's almost worth watching this codec scene just to see Otacon's face again, but since we're skipped through it, we'll see it anyway. Look at that. Look at that. Just right up in there. Who says now die? Like, that's a great evil villain thing to say. The trick with this, I think, is get in the corner so they can't get behind you. And just shoot at them. Oh, there's one of them left. Oh, yep, got them all. Like a boss. That's all that camera angle is there for. I have no... It's a video game, Coaster Freak. I have no idea. It's entirely possible. It's entirely possible. He asked if elevators aren't even supposed to move if the weight limit is exceeded. That's probably right. That seems like the kind of factual inconsistency that Metal Gear would, you know, just ignore for story purposes. PSG-1 bullets. A high D. Alright, let's go. Now that we killed all those dudes, nothing stops Solid Snake. Let's go. Oh, we went up those stairs. Where am I going? Where's the door? Oh, there it is. Okay. Six card. I think there's a camera right there. Yes, there is. Shaft grenade. That's right, I got your number, game. You had me before, but not this time. This is probably a hole with a lot of guns in it. Yep. Ah, damn it. I vaguely recall this hallway being annoying. Okay. Yeah, also, you can't pick up those prototype suits. I mean, I guess you shot them full of holes, so they probably don't work that well anymore. Like, those guys should appear once you start shooting them. Also, so we're about to come up on the Sniper Wolf boss fight here, part two. Part two. Can't see anything. Actually, I think you can see. Oh, there. By the way, there's that other fast travel truck, so now you can go all the way back to the first area if you've got the other boxes and the second area. But, let's see here, night vision goggles, and then, can I do the scope? How do I zoom in and out? Oh, there we go. Aha! Let's see here. Survey the area. Let's turn all the way to the right over here. What's this? A parachute? Dun, dun, dun! It seems Liquid's death was greatly exaggerated. So how should we do this, guys? Let's... You know what? I'm gonna do this... like Metal Gear style, and do it multiple ways. Oh, wow. I like that your body flashes, like, just in case you didn't realize you got hit.
Snake, are you okay?
Otacon, were there any other stealth prototypes?
No, there were only five.
So, this isn't stealth camouflage then?
What are you talking
it's
about?
It's regular
Someone's
camouflage.
Aiming at me in the middle of this blizzard.
It's her!
Wolf? Sniper Wolf?
Yes, it's her. It's definitely her.
Otacon, you sound like you're happy.
No, I'm not.
So then what is it?
Snake, please don't kill her.
Are you insane?
Does she make you horny, baby? Does she make you randy?
You'd know that if you talk to her.
Listen to me, kid. She's a merciless killer.
I can see you perfectly from here.
How did you get this number?
I told you.
Seriously, like, at this point, Snake has to wonder if she can tune into this conversation that easily and quickly. How does he not know that they're totally not just listening to him this entire game? Like, they could have just everything, all these conversations with Colonel, everybody. Have to know.
Wolf, don't do this.
Snake, I'm near. Can't you sense me near you?
It's a mistake for a sniper to reveal our location.
Is that right? Well, I'm going to send you a love letter, my dear. Do you know what that is? It's a bullet straight from my gun to your heart.
Please, Wolf! Snake, no!
Quiet! Don't get in our way!
No. Quiet is in Metal Gear Solid 5.
You men are so weak. You could never finish what you start.
She's got the Jennifer Aniston bob hair to her as well. That probably lends to the 90s shampoo commercial air that Coaster Freak is assigning her. Chat here. Okay, so there's basically two ways to do this boss fight. I'll show you the first, you know, the proper way and the way I originally did it when I did it the first time, which is properly scope her out and counter sniper.
Damn it.
And not be an idiot and zoom out like at a critical moment. So there's bullet travel as well, so, like... God damn it, my diazepam wore off. This fight is much tougher without the diazepam. There we go. So it's sniping her like this. Ah! And then when you get hit, your aim goes way off. The other way, which is way better, and way easier, because Metal Gear is so open and you can kind of do whatever you want, is to just chill over here. I think you have to stand behind this berm. And if you see, when I go in first person, she can't really, it provides a much smaller target for her to hit. By standing here, equip the Nikita and then fire that first person mode, and it actually, because of the lay of the land here, I think, oh no, that's not the spot. That's right. Yeah, over here you can go up. I'll go with the, rise with the, and boom! She can't hit you from over here. Best. Well, I mean, you can do it with either way. I mean, I the first time I beat her with the PSG-1. You can totally do this like a regular sniper fight if you want. Kind of like the ends where you have to counter-snipe him the whole time. In MGS3, but this is the by far the easier way to do it, is with the Nikita. Yeah, third person, I prefer, like, I can easier see the slope in first person, so it's easier to sort of make your way up over here. There is a limited amount of time on the rocket as well, so, like, if you mess up, like you see in the top left corner there is a, there for the fuel, I'm guessing, for the rocket. Yeah, this is by far the easiest way to do this boss fight. Ah! I missed. There's... Like every Metal Gear boss fight, there are multiple ways to accomplish what you're trying to do. Some of them much more effective than others. I'm just gonna weaken her quite a bit, and then I'll probably do the last couple sniper style, because I really like doing it like a proper sniper fight. That's way more interesting. And this way is just kind of cheap. Actually. I mean, it's not cheap, because it's you had to figure it out, right? But... Here's the third person for you, Coaster Freak. Where is she at? See, the other advantage of first person is you can see better where she's at. Okay. Let's switch to PSG-1. Don't lie down yet. Sweeping to the right. Move. You move and lie down again regularly. Okay, there. See where she's aiming from based on the targeting reticle. Use that ration real quick. Where's the body armor? There we go. Got her. Proper way. That was the So the end sniper boss battle in the third Metal Gear Solid, yes, if you leave and come back, Naked Snake and the old man are doing it. No, they're not. He dies of old age. Yeah, so in this one, this is only way to finish it is by killing Sniper Wolf. So, like I just did.
I waited for this moment. I am a sniper.
For a moment like this.
Never moving a muscle.
I have waited.
I am long shot.
This scene has quite a bit of dramatic flair to it, despite being, please, you know, highly polygonal and underwhelming
just
graphically.
Finish me quick. I am a guard. I have always dreamed of a peaceful place like this.
So I decided to shoot everybody in it.
So that's why you're called Wolf.
I was born on a battlefield. Raised on a battlefield. Gunfire, sirens, and screams. They were my lullabies.
Snake has some weird...
hunted like dogs.
...camaraderie with all of the bosses in this game. Like, this is the one game where... like you can draw parallels between every single one of them and him.
Was my life.
Except maybe Decoy Octopus, but that's not.
Each morning I'd wake up and find a few more of my family or friends dead beside me.
L'Oreal Wolf.
Stare at the morning sun.
Because you're worth it.
And pray to make it through the day. The governments of the world turned a blind eye to our misery. But then, he appeared. My hero. Saladin. He took me away from all that.
Saladin? You mean Big Boss?
I became a sniper.
I mean, for a game doing this at this time, like, this level of storytelling was just unprecedented. That's what blew me away about this and got me back into gaming in a big way with this first Metal Gear Solid. I didn't think game stories could be like this. For the most part, I thought they were excuses of, you know, having just shooting galleries full of enemies like Halo and stuff like that. And Halo had a better story than most, you know, to me at the time. And I sat down and played this, and it just, like, something that could be so deep and self-serious and yet, you know, poking fun of itself. And the gameplay is rock solid, and the, you know, the...
I am no longer...
you know, the graphics are a little dated by now, but just the level of storytelling in this game is...
sold my body and my soul.
You know, I remember the games I was playing on PlayStation, and this... nothing could touch this, like, to me, from what I'd played back there.
Wolves, you know, noble animals.
As far as story goes. To me, story in games was always an afterthought, like the gameplay, and I enjoyed that. But, like, playing this game showed me that games could be more.
Keglenek, and the Aleuts revere them as honorable cousins. They call mercenaries like us dogs of war. It's true.
Diamond dogs?
You're different. Untamed. Solitary. You're no dog. You're a wolf.
Who are you?
Your worst nightmare.
Wolf. You spared Meryl's life.
She was never my real target. I don't kill for sport.
Rest easy. You'll die as the proud wolf you are.
I finally understand. I wasn't waiting to kill.
Doesn't Otacon show up in this scene being all mopey and weird in like 5 seconds?
For someone to kill me. A man like you. You're a hero. Please, set me free.
Why?
Yep.
Why? I loved you.
I don't... Otacon, that's like being in love with a stripper. Like, no, she doesn't love you back, man.
She's
what are you?
Part of me.
Ugh, sniveling idiot, man. What are you doing? Otacon, you're so stuck in the friend zone, like you don't even know what that is. Even in death, she picked her gun over you, man. What are you doing? And then there's all that shit in MGS2 that I don't even want to think about. Ugh. Your love life, man, you need some work.
You said that love could bloom on the battlefield. But I couldn't save her. What are you doing?
Returning it to its owner. I don't.
I'm not saying strippers aren't people. I'm saying they're absolutely people.
I don't.
They're people performing a service. But if you go to a strip club, and
I'm going to the underground base.
Think that the stripper is into you.
I know.
That's their job, is to make you think that they're into you.
If I can't stop Metal Gear, this whole place will probably be bombed to hell.
And this is even less of the case. Yeah. Now he's just pining after a woman who just does not even notice him, for the most part.
I'll hang on to my codec.
Other than, he was taking care of the dogs when I got here, so. And I like wolf dogs, so don't kill him. Oh, she didn't kill me. She must like me.
Snake! What was she fighting for? What am I fighting
Money.
For?
Money.
What are you fighting for?
Your mom.
If we make it through this, I'll tell you.
Because I haven't thought of an answer yet.
Okay. I'll be searching too.
Oh, so he actually read it like that. I believe, yeah, this is the way we go on, so. Check all the other rooms. I'm gonna need a level 7 card. Making me come back here. What are you doing? Ooh, I have a level 6 card. So if I can find the box that'll take me here. I think it's around here somewhere. I can go get the other stuff that I couldn't get before. Yeah, so, I mean, if you made it over here, they tell you you can totally use the missile launcher for this boss fight. Oh, there's more diazepam. I hate how many chaff grenades you have to use this late in the game. Like, this is ridiculous. Yep, cardboard box C, there we go. And some rations. That was a good one to go in. I think that's it. Yeah, that's where he came out. Let's make our way around the outside edge here, just make sure we didn't miss anything like that ration. Yep, those are cameras. Thank you, chaff grenades. that it? One more. And door 7, which I can't go in. Oh, more sniper bullets. Moss bullets. I wonder if you could do this boss fight, like, with the SOCOM or something. Just, like, run over here. You probably wouldn't be able to get close. She'd just snipe you before you got there. Right, of course. There's, yeah. Not only is there are there cameras, there's also mines. So, good luck with that. Oh, this one doesn't have cameras. It's just got mines. Let's see here. Mine detector. Yep. Mines everywhere. Ugh, and I can't pick them up. There's got to be a way to blow up the claymores without... Did that defuse them? No, they're still there. Yeah, because he can't blow them up. That's just the lamest mechanic. Dead bodies, making circles around dead bodies. Alright, cool. Now, let's show off the stupid, weird thing that Kojima built into this game, because why not? Oh, right, not this box, because we're at the snowfield. So let's go... Let's go all the way back to the tank hangar. So, this so cardboard box A, to heliport. Actually, you know what? It might be faster to go to... nuclear warhead storage building, even if we're going to, you know what, let's go to the heliport.
Is this all there is to load? To the heliport, huh?
Such a weird, like, dumb thing. Like, imagine you were hiding in this thing in a box and just suddenly, oh shit! What the hell is going on? Cool part, though, is now I'm back at the heliport with my whole arsenal. So now... And I suck. Use another chaff grenade. Unbelievable. And it's just gonna keep spawning, guys. I'm just going in here. If it wasn't clear from the other videos you've watched, I am by no means an expert at this game. In fact, I'm like the exact opposite of that. Let's just park here and not deal with the box that was loaded in the back that we actually drove over here for. Ugh. Watch, there's not going to be anything in this area either. I'm going to have gone all the way back here for nothing. Why is there water in the air vent? Like... That wouldn't that defeat the entire purpose of the air vent working? It's not exchanging air anymore if there's water in there. Can't see the radar when you're in intrusion view. Colonel, what's intrusion view? It's when you can't see shit because you're in first person. I think there's a couple of rooms down here in the basement that you can't get to earlier. I was lucky. I saw him coming. Basement 2, right? Right. You know what? I should have done this back when I got out of the torture chamber, and I didn't, like an idiot. Well, whatever, I'm going in here. Don't follow me. Oh shit, that's right, I totally forgot. In MGS1, you can run off screen and they won't follow you. Not till MGS2. That is stupid cheap, so if they load a new area, you just, you know, run out of the area. Yep, see, that door's a 6. That's, I got shot up. What is behind door number 1? Stinger missiles, stun grenades, chaff grenade. Whoop, I need that. One more. More stinger missiles. So that would have been useful before the Hind D boss fight, I guess, but. Camera! Oh, shoot, that would have been cool to have earlier. There's some weird stuff you can do with the camera in this game. I like that the explosion for the chaff grenades is just like a smaller version of the grenade explosion, like, sprite. Just shrunk down so it actually looks higher res. There is, I agree with you, Coaster Freak, there is something about this one and, to a slightly lesser extent, the second one being in that top-down view. And, like, these two games, they just play a certain way. I think Portable Ops would have probably been better if it didn't use that modified MGS3 control screen with 3D camera controls. It would have been better if it was top-down. Obviously, Peace Walker and Onward, they went to the, like, face button aiming thing, but I don't know. I'd like to see another, like, top-down Metal Gear like this. Like, full production values and everything, just, you know, fixed camera angles. I think I've got everything else in here, so let's go this way. Let me, because Kojima gotta always check, double check with the thermal goggles. Yeah, I'm super nervous about that. Oh, and then this whole field is gonna be full of mines again. Well, I don't need weapons. I need the mine detector. Mine detector. Alright. La da dee da 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 da. Get up. Ah, come on. I pressed the crouch button. That could have been real bad. Again. I could have just walked around those. I don't know what I'm doing. What's the point if I can't even pick them up? Oh, there's gonna be another ration in here. So, Coaster Freak, you missed most of the last stream, but I spent a lot of time in this room getting real good at it. Like, just from having to redo that torture sequence over ended up having to redo this room a couple times, and then fail the torture sequence, hadn't saved, had to go back through this room again. Kind of annoying. But I got real good at sneaking through it without even taking any guards out. I just kind of run through it now. Dun dun. Dun dun. Good music in this game. Come on. Slowest guard ever. I'm gonna pace leisurely back and forth, but I'm gonna stand in spots for like a good 30 seconds. Just gotta do my exercises while I'm waiting. Right, can't go in there because Meryl's not in there anymore. Kill the guy taking a piss! Oh, snap. Legitimately, snap, because I snapped his neck. Heal when I only have a sliver of health left in, because why not? Extra ration. Did I kill all the dudes in here? No, there's still a guy. Well, the good news is, Silence SOCOM saves the day! Best thing. Like, seriously, it virtually breaks the game. Actually, in Twin Snakes, it legitimately breaks the game, because you can aim in first person. So, like, there's just zero challenge. You just walk around headshotting everybody with the Trank rifle. Or the Silent SOCOM the second you get it. The one addition they did make to Twin Snakes was that you can do a no-kill playthrough of Twin Snakes where you can't in this one. But I don't think you can do no kills on the bosses in Twin Snakes. I don't think they added the stamina system. Maybe they did. I don't remember. Actually. What is the medicine? Oh, it's diazepam. What medicine? Cold medicine. Oh, right! Because if you're hanging out in the snow too long, you can catch a cold. This game is so weird. Totally forgot that was a thing. Gun bullets. It's just like a office building. Don't worry about it. Let's see here. I think this room had the cardboard box in it, actually. Alright, down to basement 2 real quick, and then we'll hop back on the truck. And back to the snowfield. I think we got everything now. Gas mask. Action. Totally useless. I like quick toggling in and out of menus in this area. Switching between the gas mask and the keycard. There's probably something in there useful, but I don't have it anymore. Oh, damn. Come on. Well, the good news is that ration is still back there, so maybe use that on my way out.
say to you?
Just stock it up on all this shit, just in case, you know. Never know what we're gonna run into up here. Just wasting check grenades left and right. Don't even have to waste that other. Go back in that other. Just run the hell out of it. Ah, like an idiot. And then now I have to. Because I'm an idiot. Alright, let's go get some oxygen now first. Just so we don't have to. It's more life, because we choked to death. Okay, that's good enough. I don't have a guitar. Let's just go. I mean, I don't even need a gas mask. Rations. Guard. Rations. Nothing of use down here. Got everything back on the truck. Because I'm not walking all the way back through there. I really like the soundtrack in 3 specifically, because it's got that sort of like 60s vibe to it. But yeah, otherwise this would probably be my favorite soundtrack of the bunch. Definitely the most iconic. It has the most memorable. Like, you hear this song, you think of this room. Like, it's there's definitely a lot of that in this game, where there's not as much in the other games. Although, except maybe 2. 2 had a bit of it, like with the different boss battle themes and stuff. 2 had that smooth jazz going on, which was pretty good. Okay, let's just chill out.
Moves us.
Is this all there is to load? The snowfield north of the towers, huh?
Just in case you didn't remember what snowfield it was. It's the one north of the towers, not the one south of the towers. There's a wolf now. Sniper wolf is dead. Her body's actually gone, too. I don't know what happened with that, but I really hate that they make you backtrack for that door, but whatever. I'll come back here later. Alright. Quickly through here. And now for the moment, the disc change. That's such a cool thing where it all flies in. If you're really good at this game, this is the first time you see that because you haven't died like 50 times. All right, and we're emulating this on PS3, so switching to disc 2, that's the only other option. Yes, so I want to go ahead. Press the start button after inserting disc 2. Now checking. We quote-unquote inserted disc 2. I think we can actually go back there, but it bars us from going to earlier areas as much, which is why I wanted to do that backtracking thing right there without having to switch back and forth between the two discs. This room, I remember this room. Unlike the other nuclear warhead storage room, I can use my guns in this room. Look at this shit. You don't even know I'm here. Oh, god damn it. Really? Nobody even up here. Check on that. It's gonna be called off before anybody gets up here. That was funny. Ah, the foundry room. This is a cool room. Unique environment. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but looks cool. Stun grenades. Stun grenades, huh? Problem with playing these games, especially this first one, is I just end up saying everything in Snake's voice all the time. Sneak it along with the rats. I got knocked off of this so many times when I was playing it the first time. Oh no, I'm nervous. There we go. Let's see where the dude's at. He will hear you on that walkway if he's underneath. Well, here he comes. Silent SOCOM for the win. Just breaks the game. Straight up does, though. You can just kind of shoot everybody from off screen. You no longer really have to worry about enemies. As long as you've got bullets for the SOCOM, you're pretty gold. It's just the one guy. There are a lot of rations in this room. There's an ominous number of rations in this room. Wonder what could possibly be on this. Let's see. So, we've met... let's see, who have we met? We've met Psycho Mantis. We've met Sniper Wolf. We haven't met Vulcan Raven or Decoy Octopus. Actually, we did run into Vulcan Raven. He blew up his tank, but he was still alive. And we haven't met Decoy Octopus yet. And we took down Liquid Snake, but we know he survived because of the parachute. So, pretty good guess as to who's left. Even if you haven't played this before. Whoop! Oh, that was a... Whoa, that could have been real bad. Oh, like that. I'm an idiot. Can't shoot the cameras. It'd be cool if you could shoot the cameras. Like the later ones. Yet another thing Twin Snakes added to this game to make it even more ridiculously easy. Stinger missiles. Giving me a lot of Stinger missile ammo. I'm wondering about that. I don't think a guy named Decoy Octopus would probably require use of a Stinger missile launcher to kill him, but a big hulking shaman dude named Vulcan Raven might be a good thing for him. Just saying. Oh, snap! I totally forgot about this section. I do remember this section now. I had forgotten about it previously. I remember it because it's super annoying and you have to go back through it again. But I also remember it for one other reason. So we take this elevator down.
There he is!
And then suddenly there's a bunch of dudes jumping down with me.
Damn.
We're gonna fuck your shit up, Snake. It's a good thing I've got a FAMAS again. There's the, So not only can you carry more rations later in the game here, like, they refill more of your health than they did at the beginning, it's just gets to the point where the game actually becomes easier. You have more of an arsenal to deal with enemies. Yeah, you have boss battles and stuff like this, but, like, just minimal. It gets harder in other ways, but it's not really, like, raising the difficulty, not in the traditional sense. Oof, made it down that elevator ride. Gonna run out here and just keep going with everything that we were gonna do originally. And it'd be a shame. Oh, you know what? Oh, I can't do that because there's a. It's jamming, but there's freaking mines everywhere here. And I remember. Ah, god damn it. Really? Not only are there. Oh, what? What game? What? That's bullshit. Not only are there frickin' mines, there's a frickin' camera, too. Great. Where are the chaff grenades? Yeah, if you just run through here. If the camera doesn't get you, the mines will. It's bullshit. It's all bullshit. This whole room is bullshit. Or maybe it's later when you have to backtrack through here. Might be later. Nope! No, it was right now. God damn it, this fucking game. There are very few parts in this game that are complete bullshit. This is one of them. It's the, we're gonna jam your radar and put a camera there and put mines there. It's pure garbage. So you can't use the mine detector. Can you use the... Oh, you know what? You can use the thermal goggles, though, to see where the mines are. I think. Well, that was... Ah! Fucking a cord. Ah! Damn it. Good thing that's a ration. Because I freaking need it. Go back to that. Back to the other room and get all those extra rations. That way, we should go to something else. Yeah. Shit. Oh, right. And the camera can still see you. Garbage. Pure garbage. There's crows or ravens around suddenly.
Snake. I've got something to tell you about Naomi Hunter.
What about her?
Is this conversation secure?
Don't worry, the monitor's off.
Okay.
What's up?
I was in the FBI too, you know.
I didn't know that. What's your point?
Dr. Hunter's story about her background, about her grandfather being an assistant secretary to Hoover in the FBI.
Yeah.
And then going undercover to investigate the mafia in New York.
Yeah, what about it?
It was all a big lie.
What did you say?
It was really bothering me. Why would she lie about it?
She lied.
Why indeed?
She might be a spy.
Ridiculous.
Come on, even a high school student could see past it. The head of the FBI at that time, Edgar Hoover, he was a well-known racist. Didn't Naomi say that her father was Japanese?
Yeah.
Well, back then, there wasn't a single Asian investigator.
I think the biggest argument for Naomi's hair actually being black the whole time is that her father is Japanese.
They first started in 1960.
Not a lot of Japanese people with, like, actual brown hair.
But you better check it out. The chief and the president mysteriously...
To dredge up an argument from, like, two streams ago.
Too many strange things are happening.
Are you saying that Naomi might be behind it?
I don't know. Either that, or she's working with the terrorists.
Could it be?
If I find out anything, I'll call. In the meantime, be careful.
It's real cold. Looks real cold here. And turn on the thermogoggles, see if anything shows up again, because, you know, Kojima. You can see the polygonal outlines of those ravens, and they just look like paper planes flying around. It's real dumb looking. C4. Right, you can totally use a C4 in this fight. Sort of like an amalgamation of your earlier battles. Take what you've learned up to this point and use it against Vulcan Raven! I probably should have saved. Well.
This is the end of the road.
Excuse me? What did you call me?
My friends. Listen.
Listen. Listen to the ravens, huh? You know, buddy, you might need to get some more friends. I don't know how long you've been in Alaska. This is a big ass. I like that it's just he's got this minigun. It's like, how does he keep firing bullets? Let's just put this massive drum of bullets on his back that could not possibly ever be, you know, run out.
The Ravens and I were testing to see what kind of man you were. The judgment is decided. The Ravens say you are a true warrior.
That's kind of ridiculous. Like this crazy shaman with like a huge-ass minigun.
I can't move.
The Raven has put the mark of death upon you. Blood from the East flows within your veins.
Also, that's a weird line.
Your ancestors, too, were raised on the barren plains of Mongolia. Inuit and Japanese are cousins to each other. We share many ancestors, you and I.
I don't have any crows in my family tree.
You jest, but indeed, Raven.
I like the just overt reference here that Snake is Japanese.
Nevertheless, you will make a worthy.
Many characters in this game are Japanese, even though they're like supposed to be American in the English translation. But they couldn't come up with anything better, so they just say that they're Japanese.
Must be a real threat in the muckduck eating contest.
Yes, you are right. But there is another event that I excel at. It is called
Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Contest in New York.
It is an event where two opponents.
I took second place behind the skinny Asian man one time. And ever since then, I've had a grudge against the Japanese. That's really why I want to kill you, Snake.
Different, but the spirit is the same. Rejoice, Snake. Ours will be a glorious battle.
This is now, glorious. We shall eat hot dogs to the death!
Violence isn't a sport.
Well, we'll see if there is iron in your words.
Alright. First things first, body armor on. Let's do... Right, we have to a lot of health. We can get our body. Other stack of watch this thing. Same boss battle music, but so good. And what? I need to pay more attention to the game and less to this whole time. This is the GTA problem of you're always looking at the mini map, so you're not paying attention to what's going on. Got him. It's super effective. wonder how long it would take to film this up like a FAMAS. Suck. Ah, come on. Oh, shit. Rations are frozen. I can't use them. Don't die. Don't. Ah, damn it. Alright, let's try this again.
Snake, answer me. Snake? Snake?
At the end there, it actually might be easier to use the C4. Just wait till I know where he is and know it. Do that. This. As you land more hits, he moves more quickly.
Come on now.
Not happening. Oh, shit. Come on. Running fast enough, it might be easier to use the C4. Oh. Ah. Oh, what? That would have been perfect. Nice. I'm just gonna fire before he's even visible. Got him. Not too bad, considering.
Just as the
boss said. she lasted that long getting shot in the face with a stinger missile that many times. I think the Hind D took less shots.
But my body.
This is a pretty gnarly way to go, by the way.
My spirit and my flesh will become one.
He means they're gonna eat him.
In that way, I will return to Mother Earth who bore me. Snake! I will be watching you. Understand?
I'll know if you've been naughty or nice.
Snake, take this security card. It will open that door.
Now that he's dying, screw it. Just why? Forget about his boss's plans.
You are
just,
a snake
here you go.
Which was not created by nature. You and the boss, you are from another world. A world that I do not wish to know. Go and do battle with him. I will be watching from above. First, I'll give you a hint. The man who you saw die before your eyes.
What is it?
Why?
First clue as to what happened to the DARPA chief here.
Was not the DARPA chief.
Sorry if I've been spoiling that.
A member of Foxhound.
For the entire stream. But it's just too weird of a thing.
He copied his subjects down to the blood. So he drained the chief's blood and took it into himself. But he was.
That's a white guy.
Angel of Death.
The Angel of Death. But why go to so much trouble? Why impersonate the chief?
That is the end of my hint. You must solve the rest of.
We're not going to answer any of this. Until you beat the game.
In the natural world, there's no such thing as.
And even then, it won't make any sense. Oh, gross. Yeah, that's the part where Snake just kind of turns away, because he doesn't really want to watch this guy get eaten alive by ravens. That's real gnarly way to go.
Each step you take is paved with the corpses of your enemies. You shall have no peace. Hear me, Snake.
I feel like that music is appropriate. Damn. Well, and he's gone. Ooh. I want the minigun. Push select.
Snake, it's me.
Master.
It's about Naomi. Turn your monitor off.
What about Naomi? Colonel, is Naomi there?
No, she's away. She's taking a short nap. So what is this about Naomi?
Okay, maybe we better let the Colonel hear this too.
Yeah, go on.
Since he's already heard about
it, you basically,
know.
Dr. Naomi Hunter is not Dr. Naomi Hunter at all.
What?
And then yet, like, when they bring her back later, she's still Naomi, but, alright.
And? There is an actual Dr. Naomi Hunter, or I should say, there was one. But she's not the woman we know. The real Naomi Hunter disappeared somewhere in the Middle East. Our Naomi must have somehow obtained her identification papers.
So then, who is she really?
She must be some kind of spy.
A spy?
Yes. Maybe she's been sent to sabotage this operation.
Are you saying she's with the terrorists?
I don't want to believe it either, but she is working for Foxhound.
So you think she had a part in the uprising?
Or she could be working with some different group altogether.
Different group? It couldn't be.
Place her under arrest.
What?
She's betrayed us. She needs to be arrested and interrogated.
I'm giving the orders now.
If she's one of their spies, then we're in big trouble.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing. Have you let her in on some kind of vital secret or something? Does this have anything to do with the mysterious deaths of the DARPA chief and the Arms Tech president?
I have no idea.
Because I'd really like to know more about that. Just so you know, none of the rest of us will die. The rest of who?
We can't complete this mission.
Us, the people on this mission. I thought you were in a house somewhere way far away. Yeah. That's. I'm just curious.
I understand. Snake, give me some time. I don't have any time left for you.
I'm sick of your shit, Colonel. Oh, hey, there's the ration. A bloody chain gun. That's a cool effect that I never actually noticed before during that boss fight. If he shoots enough of the bottom of one container, it'll collapse and the other container on top will fall off. But it's, I mean, I noticed that those were blocking it, but I didn't notice that it had to do with how much he was standing in a particular corner and firing his chain gun that way. Okay, so now we have a level 7 card, so we can go back and get that stuff at the snowfield. So let's do that now. Just practicing my Tai Bo. Snake is far from a master of CQC at this point. He's a big boss anyway. Breakdancing. This is a long ass. This is a stupid way to disguise a loading screen, because this is really long-ass elevator ride. Kind of annoying, to be honest. Okay. Right. Gun camera and claymores. So, chaff grenade, and then we want the thermal gun. FAMAS bullets. Another elevator. It's like Predator vision, or Terminator vision. I think it'll make me change discs again to go back. Real dumb thing to do. Oh, right, I'm in here again. Yep, I was like, are these guards alive again? Yeah, they're totally alive. Get all these He's robbed. Oh my god, that's an awful way to die. I hope that checkpoint is... That elevator is way too long. Okay, gosh. Jeez. Ugh. Talk about a bad way to go. Fight all these dudes and then... Oh, shit! And then you do that twice in a row. Dying for this stupid guy. Shit. Oh, there's. I just. Right there. I'm just trying to pop. Okay. Let's try that one more time. Yeah, there's not really an easy way to. That thing is just there to kill you, I think. I legitimately think the only reason that ration is there is to make you try to get it and kill yourself. Because I can't think of a reason you shouldn't be able to get that ration. The thing Mei Ling was saying about don't go after shit. It's not worth it. Where would they put that? That's super annoying. Murder fools. Drop rations. Yes, I can. I don't have to do this thing. I don't have to sneak back across that thing. Okay, so it shouldn't have me load the second disc here, hopefully. So we can just continue with the brief use of a chaff grenade. Watch, there's going to be, like, nothing useful in this room whatsoever. It's just going to be, like, a... Three cameras. All aimed right at you. Yeah, just stinger missiles, which I just used. Great, super useful. That was the level 7 drone. Ugh. Died that many times for that. At least I found out what was in the room. Curiosity, if nothing else.
else in here. It doesn't matter. Oh, my ashes are frozen. Aw, come on. Just spawn that guy just to mess with me. That door didn't have a key card. Need for it. Super Spy Solid Snake. More ammo everywhere. Another couple long ass elevator rides. Good time to contemplate life. Meaning of, oh, it's almost done. Oh goody, another elevator ride. So, let's see where we're... yes, we were contemplating the meaning of... ...42, I think it's probably a pretty good answer to that. I don't know what the question is. Therma G. What's up, my Therma G? Those paper airplane ravens are pretty good. I figured they'd be gone out of this area after the Vulcan Raven was dead. That rations freezing thing is just foreshadowing for later. What you feel like we'll actually have to deal with. It's reminding you that things can freeze. Oh. Unlike Sniper Wolf, nobody seems to. Well, his body disappeared because the Raven ate it, so. I guess no one can lift his minigun, so that's just gonna stay there. Oh, right! This hallway, which is real dumb. Okay, hold on. Thermal goggles. I think this is, yep, all trap doors here. And then, so you get to the end of the trap doors. And let me throw a shaft right here. Because. Oh my god, look at all these cameras! What in the hell? Ah, shit. Should have thrown that earlier. Stinger misses. More stinger misses. So many cameras. Is there a way to destroy those? There might be. I'm not. Maybe with the stinger missiles, actually, is probably a good way to do it. I'm not going to bother with that. Just take forever. It's not really worth it. Just blow a couple chaff grenades. Get through there. Uh-oh. What is this? Metal Gear. Alright. That, I think, is a good time to save. We're gonna call it here for tonight. I have to go to work tomorrow, so unfortunately.
Naomi wasn't acting strangely or anything?
No, I just can't believe that Naomi's an enemy spy. I refuse to accept that.
I don't want to believe it either, but.
Don't say it, Snake.
Don't say it and it won't be true. So we had a good run here. This is a good place to call it, but I want to thank you for tuning in. And tomorrow night will be the grand finale, I think, looks like here, of Metal Gear Solid. We've gotten to Metal Gear. We're in the underground base. All we have to do now is stop the launch. So, thanks for sticking around. If you want to see more content like this, go check out theexperiencebar.com. It's a website about video games that I write for and post new content and do stupid, silly stuff like this. So, go check that out at you know, theexperiencebar.com. If you want to find out when we're doing more streams like this, you can follow me on Twitter at @srosalyn or The Experience Bar on Twitter at @theexpbar. And see what we've got coming up and when we have new articles and stuff like that. We've also got a Facebook present, facebook.com/TheExperienceBar, so check that out too if you're on Facebook. But most importantly, go check out TheExperienceBar.com for news, reviews, and things of that nature. So thank you for joining us. This has been part 3 of The Experience Bar Streams Metal Gear Solid, and part 4, which will likely be the finale here, featuring Metal Gear, of Metal Gear Solid, will be coming tomorrow night. So, thanks for watching, and we'll see you then.